You know, I just can't imagine another world like this or people in it like us. I mean, where is it now and why can't I see it?
I think that's because, Will, we only have one pair of these, which enables us to just see 1/100th of what's going on out there.
When we lived in the old house in Harrisville.
What?
There used to be someone in my room sometimes. I mean, I could really see her. I couldn't see her when I looked at her straight, only when I saw her through the corner of my eye. It wasn't scary or anything like that.
That happens to everyone. You think you're seeing someone out of the corner of your eye. That's not what Dad's talking about.
After a while, I used to pretend like she was my sister. Maybe she was.
The truth is out there, but in order to find the truth, you must first believe. If you don't have no passion for wanting to know anything outside your comfort zone, you know, and that requires an open mind, then you're never going to find the truth, and you'll never, you know, free your life from this system, because the very system itself is based upon you know, this type of shit. And it says, free your eyes, eternal prize. There's a part right in the beginning of this music video that gives you a hint to what they're talking about when they say, you know, free your eyes, eternal prize. And I'm going to show you guys here right now. So, as you guys can notice, the kid looks like an alien hybrid, and throughout this music video, it shows the kid, that same exact kid, walking through Hollywood, being surrounded by, you know, paparazzi and signing autographs, what they're trying to show with that kid is that these celebrities out there, you know, and like these musicians and these I don't want to say politicians, because it seems to me that they're mainly focusing on Hollywood, but what I'm the message I'm getting is these celebrities are you know, hybrids, are either one, hybrids, or two, human hosts for alien beings, and you know, and they're vessels, you know, they're not real people, or at least not, you know, 100%, you know, real people. But anyways, right here, you see this kid, this same kid, peeking around the corner right here. Give me a moment. So do you see that? He peeks around the corner. They all see the kid out of the corner of their eyes, and then the kid runs across the hallway, and they all noticed. They turn their heads, but they aren't going to see the kid. Even when the kid is standing right in front of them, so you know, so. The message they're saying, you know, is that, you know, you sometimes see these aliens out of the corner of your eyes. And, you know, I mean, and we've, and I think we all had these moments, you know, before. I know I have. I've seen these these entities many times out of the corner of my eyes, but when I turn my head and I go to look, you know, directly at them, you know, I don't see nothing. So you know, free your eyes, eternal prize. It's like, you know, you're hypnotized on some level, you know, by the system, by these aliens. You gotta, you know, lose. I mean, you know, and you have to be open to that fact. You have to be open to the possibilities. Lose small mind. You free your life, free your eyes. Eternal prize. You know, here in the beginning, you see them performing from a circus tent, and circus sounds a lot like the word circuit. You know, like where, you know, energy goes, you know, circuit board, you know, energy pathways and all that. And they say that planet Earth is comparable to a circus. Again, you know, this makes me think of the movie, Killer Clowns from Outer Space, 1988. That film that came out in 1988. And clowns have always been associated with reptilian, they're symbols of reptilian possession, you know. Specifically, the clown, you know, symbolizes, the red-headed Rh-negative hybrid, you know, host. Because they say that red-headed people, ginger people, and I don't mean to say it in a way to where, you know, it sounds racist. I don't know if calling red-headed people gingers or not is equivalent to calling, like, a black person, you know, the N-word. But, I mean, if some of you feel that way, then, you know, my bad. But yeah, they say Rh-negative hybrids, they say the Rh-negative factor is, you know, the most prevalent in red-headed people. You know, European redheads have the highest percentage of Rh-negative blood. And they say that redheaded people, these Rh negative people, are the direct descendants of the Nephilim, you know, these reptilian hybrids, which were said to be redheaded giants of the ancient past that used to eat people. So, you know, you got the clown, and the clown, you know, clowns have always been associated with the circus tents. The typical clown has its red hair, and you know, that symbolizes, you know, the redhead. And then the pasty white skin that clowns normally have symbolizes, again, you know, the skin of a white person, you know, European. Redheaded people have pasty white skin. And then you got the clown slits that go down across the clown's eyes, and those look exactly like the reptilian pupil, you know, a reptile's pupil. And then you notice how clowns always wear that red lipstick, and that lipstick goes all the way back towards their cheeks, so it looks like they have really big mouths. Kind of like the Joker from Batman: The Dark Knight, but the Joker had the red lipstick, but he also had a huge ass scar it's supposed to symbolize the reptilian's large dinosaur-like mouth. You know, and clowns have always been associated with a demonic, quote unquote, possession. You know, I don't like to call these beings demons, because they're not. Again, these are aliens that fucking are operating from higher dimensions, or, you know, frequencies that we just, you know, can't see, because we've been, like, hardwired, very programmed into not, you know, seeing them, hypnotized. But still, on a deep subconscious level, you know, I'd say that we're, you know, aware of these, but we just have to consciously bring it, you know, we have to bring, it's like that, it makes me think of that Carl Jung quote, you know, how's it go? I'm trying to think of it, about something about making the subconscious conscious or something like that, but I can't remember. But anyways, what else would the Joker say from Batman, you know, The Dark Knight? He would always say, why so serious? Again, you know, Sirius sounds just like, you know, the dog star Sirius, you know, from the Orion constellation where these reptilian Anunnaki are said to come from. And they deliberately stuck that in the movie, you know, The Dark Knight. I mean, you know, they wrote, I mean, the writers, you know, that wrote that script, you know, put it in there on purpose. It's an obvious, you know, it's obvious symbolism that you just know wasn't put there, you know, by mistake. Really, really high chance that it wasn't anyways. But yeah, so, you know, circus tent, clowns, killer clowns from outer space, the clowns were from outer space, you know, so that's the alien connection there. And what did those clowns do? They would abduct people, and then they would take them inside their circus tent UFO, and they would turn them into cotton candy, and then they would eat them, you know, and there you go with the, you know, the vampire, you know, aspect in it all. But you know, it's no coincidence that they would, you know, place the circus tent in this music video and then associate aerials, these aliens, with, you know, with a circus tent. And the front of that circus tent, as you can see here, kind of looks like an opening of a UFO, like, you know. But it's just, you know, it's interesting, man. There's a part in those lyrics that says, you always want to go, but you never want to stay. And that part makes me think of, like, you know, witchcraft, you know, the occult, because that's where humanity's salvation lies, you know, in the occult world, you know. And so, when the average person, you know, and I really kind of think this applies to all human beings, because when you start to, delve into that world, into the occult world, you know, where the truth is, and that's where the truth is, man. It's like, you know, the best I could compare it to is, like, you know, human beings are only subjected to, like, we only know, you know, the tip of the iceberg when it comes to, you know, the world around us, you know, the tip of the iceberg, you know, where, like, you know, but there's so much more underneath the waters of consciousness, you know, so much more to the iceberg itself. And when you start to, you know, go deeper down, because, you know, all the way down at the bottom of the iceberg is when you realize the full truth, you know, when you know it. So, you know, the deeper you swim down, the darker it gets. And the darker it gets, you know, they say that there's, you know, like, well, what do you got? And, you know, the deeper you go down, you know, the bigger, you know, these sea monsters become, like, you know, like fucking sharks and squids, and, like, you know, I mean, I, for a thing that comes to my mind is the giant squid. Imagine, you know, being that deep. I mean, and then again, I mean, a human being can't survive those kind of depths anyways without, you know, the pressure of the ocean killing you. But still, I mean, just imagine, even if you could, coming across, you know, something like, you know, a giant squid, and, you know, and that to me would be pretty scary. But you know, but, like, I made a video, another video, I mean, you could find on my channel, that says the octopus, you know, about the octopus and how the octopus symbolizes, you know, the Matrix, or symbolizes these aliens. So, you know, and that octopus, think of that octopus wrapped around that giant iceberg, you know, and you really only see the octopus, you don't see it at the tip, but you see it at, you know, when you start to dive down underneath, you know, you could equate the waters, the ocean to consciousness, you know, and when you start to delve down into the waters of consciousness and you go deeper down, you know, you'll start to, you know, start to see the arms, and when you go deeper, then the arms will, you know, get wider and then go deeper, and then pretty soon you'll see the body itself, and then, you know, the big bobulous head, the gray alien, and you know, the octopus shoots out black goo, black ink, and this black goo, you know, corrupts. So, you know, as I said in my octopus video on my channel, you know, that the octopus's tentacles are wrapped around the three bodies, the three spheres or spiritual aspects of the human soul, and that's, you know, the mental, you know, psychological aspect, and the spiritual, and then you got and that's where psychic warfare comes into play. And then you got the physical aspect, and that's, you know, them, you know, putting chemicals in our food and you know, and all kinds of different shit is in the food we eat. You know, it's very hard to really get, you know, clean food from the store without it being like super spendy and like, you know, all that. I believe is for a reason. You know, I mean, those who control this planet, you know, they want us to eat like shit. I mean, you know, but yeah, I mean, if you want more about, you know, the octopus, I'm trying to stay on topic on this video, and I don't want to go too far out with some of this shit. But if you want to understand more, you know, about where I'm coming from when it comes to you know, the octopus, check out my video, The Octopus. You know, I break down, you know, the symbolism behind that animal, how the Illuminati, you know, how it's, you know, how it symbolizes the Matrix, and it's, you know, it's probably sacred, you know, to these aliens that control us. Anyways, yeah, so
aerials in the sky, when you lose small mind, you free your life. Life is a waterfall. We drink from the river, then we turn around and put up our walls. Swimming through the void, we hear the word. We lose ourselves, but we find it all. Cause we are the ones that want.
Yeah, that's the music video for you guys, and if you guys want to check out the full video, you know where to find it. So but yeah, it's pretty interesting, man. And then you got the ladies in red, so you know, I'm sure that's symbolism right there too. I don't know the meaning behind that, but you know, and then the guy in black here, you know, looks like a kike, so you know, that's probably. You know, they're probably showing, you know, I don't know, but I don't want to trip over any of my words too hard here, and then, you know, but yeah, I'm just, all of it, I mean, this is just a very interesting music video, and the symbolism in this music video is just, it's blatant, you know, circus tent, fucking, you know, aliens, aerials associated with the circus tent, you know, humanity is the freak show, where the exploit freaks in the sense that we're not a natural product of evolution, and we're a genetically engineered species.